This is seminar on Spring Boot batch processing. We are discussing session one. Okay, so what is batch processing? We are going to see here. Okay, if you want to read the data from a source machine and you want to transform the data into one format and write to a destination machine, then we are going to use batch processing. Okay, transfer large data from source to destination with some operations. If you want to perform some operations here in the middle and you want to give it to one machine here. Okay, so what are some real-time use cases? If you just look at here, we'll be having CSV file, comma separated value, or some Excel representation format here. Okay, assumption it is having something like 10,000 rows. 10,000 rows are there here, or 10,000 data entries are there. Okay, so I just want to transfer this data to one database, something like a MySQL. Okay, or else we have something like Mongo database. Okay, Mongo database actually having large number of data. I just want to convert to some XML file format here. Okay, so one format to another format, that is actually called source to destination. Okay, so source machine to destination, there's actually source format to destination. We are going to read the data from one place. Okay, we can perform some operations and we can write it to this. Okay, that is supported by batch processing here. Okay, so this batch processing API is given by Spring Framework and auto configuration is given by Spring Boot. Okay, so let us see its API details, how it is actually going to look to work on this one. Okay, so here the actual task, what exactly we are doing, okay, sending from one to another, that is completely called as job. Actual work of batch processing is called as job. Okay, one job will be divided into multiple steps. Okay, at least one step should be there here. Okay, connecting to one source or connecting to one destination. Okay, converting the data, like we'll be having steps here. One job should contain at least one step, and every step contains three sub-steps here. We can also call that's actually item reader, item processor, and item writer. Okay, every step internally contains one reader, processor, and writer. So job contains multiple steps. Step contains a reader, processor, and writer. Reader will read the data from source machine and it will hand over to processor. We'll do some calculations, operations, logical checkings, and all here. We'll hand over to writer. Writer writes the data to destination. Okay, these are all controlled by a step, and step is controlled by a job here like this. One job should have at least one step, at most n number of steps. One step contains one reader, one processor, and one writer. Okay, this job is started by job execution listener here, sorry, job launcher. Job launcher will start the job. Okay, it will start the job execution. Okay, in simply we can call it a run method process here. It is actually going to run the job, we can call. Okay, all these details, once you execute, okay, is job executed successfully or not? How many times the step is called? Okay, is it reading the data from reader? Okay, and all the details, at what time job started, at what time job end, every details is available inside the memory. Okay, it can be a temporary database or a permanent database here. Okay, that is actually called job repository. Java repository, which stores all the details here. Okay, this is a basic design of batch processing here. Okay, we have to see some points here. So job, actual task that indicates sending data from source to destination. Okay, the actual batch processing is completely implemented by using job. But it's not directly implemented here, that is converted into multiple steps. One job can have 1 to n steps, at least one step. Most of the cases we may use single step, that is sufficient. Okay, in case of multiple destinations and source connected involved here, then we can have multiple steps also. Okay, one job can have 1 to n steps here, and every step should contain item reader. Simply I'm writing it's a reader, processor and writer. Okay, it's actually reader, processor and writer. Reader reads data from source device. Okay, processor will calculate. Okay, if you want to do any operations internally here. Okay, writer writes the data to destination. If you want to write the data to destination here, writer is used here. Okay, and this job is started by job launcher. Starts job execution. Okay, and job repository is a memory. It can be some temporary database like H2 or MySQL you can use here. Stores all details of jobs. At what time job started, step executed, are they failed or success? Okay, so all the details will be available inside the repository. It's just a memory. Okay, so here the major thing we have to speak about step. Okay, we'll take a requirement even after this diagrams. I'll take one CSV file and we'll write to one MySQL database even. Okay, I'll give some similar examples, multiple examples. We can even work with some other. Okay, so here, mainly we have to discuss about step. So how this step is actually going to work here. Okay, so let us take one source machine having some thousand records actually here. Thousand rows or thousand records or thousand entries. Thousand students details, thousand employees details like this. We have some rows. Okay, this is actually a source. I just want to transfer the data to another machine, something like a destination. Destination format, I just want to mention here. Here, source and destination can be a file or a database. It can be a file or database. Here, I'm just taking it's a CSV file, comma separated value, CSV file here. Okay, assumption is something like a database, MySQL database. I just want to read the data from this source and I want to write it to MySQL here. Mainly, whenever you call the step, whenever you call the job, step is actual one, okay, which executes almost all process here, like collection of steps created by job, that's actually creates the job here. Okay, so here the major point is actually step creation. Okay, step creation. Okay, step contains item reader, and next one item processor and item writer. Okay, so here first initially we'll be having item reader. Okay, it is actually going to read the data from the source device one by one, line by line. It will read the first row or first line data here, and once it is done here, then it is actually going to hand over to processor. Hey processor, okay, please read the data from here. So reader got the data and it handovers it. Okay, next writer is not called. Okay, for an item, for a single row, one time reader is called and one time processor is called actually here. It will read the data. Okay, it's actually going to process the data here. Okay, then it will read for next item. It will read for next item actually here. Hey, please give me next item here. Like that it will continue. Okay, again it is actually going to read the item. Okay, that is handover to processor, and again it will come next item. Okay, so for one item, one reader executed, one processor executed, or for one row, one reader executed, one processor executed. If we take 1,000 rows here, okay, 1,000 times reader executed and 1,000 times processor executed here, like that. So now the point is when writer is executed. Okay, writer will actually collect the data from the processor. Okay, so as a list collection here, it's a collection. It's actually going to collect all the records here. Okay, so here something like item one, item two, like that item three here we can mention. And we can mention one size here. That's actually chunk we call. Okay. For example, your size is something like 100. For every 100 rows, okay, processed, then writer is executed once. Writer is executed once. Okay, if you take one example here, okay, 1,000 times reader executed, 1,000 times processor executed, but item writer executed, so one time per 100 rows. Okay, around 10 times it is executed here. Okay, to make it very simple, I'll be taking just a simple example here. Okay, let us take there are 25 rows available. Okay, I just gave chunk size 10. Okay, in the 25, first row is taken. Okay, reading and processing. Second row, reading, processing. Third row, reading, processing. Fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10. After 10th, then writer is called once. Okay, because you mentioned the chunk, that's your interest. Okay, that's actually executed here. Then again, 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th, 19th, 20th. Once 20 reached here, again it will call one more time writer. Okay, for next 5 items, no more items available. So max size is 10. So one more time writer is called. So total 3 times writer is called here, but 25 times reader and 25 times processor is called here. Okay, so that's actually going to read the data, and once it is done here, it will write the data to destination here. For every chunk here, it's actually going to write the data to destination here. As a list collection, it is going to take here, okay, with a limited size. Size you can mention here. And the most important thing, whatever you see here, job, step, item reader, item processor, item writer, job launcher, these are all interfaces given by batch API. Okay, so for that, I'm just creating a dummy application here. To show the API details, I'm not writing the code now. Spring batch, just I'm creating a demo application here, not writing the code. I just want to show some details here, API details. What are what here? First, look at item reader. Control shift T, I'm using shortcut. Item reader. Make sure that you have chosen org spring framework package, not javax.bash here. This one, item reader. Control shift T. See here, item reader. It's an interface and having a generic parameter. And having one abstract method read, throwing some exceptions here, that returns same generic type T. Okay, next one, item processor. It is also interface. We are going to work with interfaces only completely. Of course, we use implementations to process. We'll take I as an input and returns O output, generic parameter. And next one here, item writer. It is also interface here, you can see. And there is a method write, and that takes a collection, some list type. Look at three interfaces here. And if you look at the generic types, whatever reader takes some type, for example, assumption it's a string type. Okay, same should be given as an input to processor. And then string converted to one employee object assumption. Okay, that is actually input is a string type, but output is actually employee object type. After processing, okay, that is actually it is given string data converted to an object, employee object. Same output type should be matching with item writer generic type. Listen, so here it will be having generics actually. Reader contains one generic T. Okay, input type, that is actually here. Okay, processor contains input and output here, and writer contains one generic type here. This generic type can be mostly string type or any particular type, it doesn't matter here. But the point, okay, reader generic type must be matching with processor input type. Processor output type must be matching with writer generic type here. Okay, so that's actually details a step required here. And if you look at here, step. Again, step is an interface here. I can see. And this step is actually created. Okay, so if you want to create a step here, what are required? Okay, step should contain a step name. If you want to create a step, okay, you need one reader, reader object. Okay, you need one processor object, implementation class object. You need one writer object. And you need, of course, chunk also here. Okay, that's actually one integer number here. Then you can create the step. By taking all these details, a step can be created by using a builder class here that is actually called step builder factory. Okay, there is a class available that is step builder factory. This class will take multiple inputs. Okay, what are the inputs required to create the step? It will take all these things and it is going to create one step here. Okay, observe. So I just want to create a single step here. What are required? Okay, reader, processor, writer interfaces, their implementations required. Okay, I just want to create a step here. Okay, every step must be identified using a name, reader object, processor class object, writer, and chunk with the input and output generic types matching details. These are all required if you want to create a single step. I'll show technical diagram at last here. And this step is created by using Step Builder Factory class. Okay, and remember, we don't write the implementations for this. Implementation class also predefined. Based on the requirement, we are going to choose here. For example, there is a flat file item reader. Okay, this is a class. Okay, where item reader is an interface, flat file item reader is a class. Okay, class is also almost predefined. Only processors we have to define manually. Okay, almost all the readers and writers are predefined. Okay, processors, what logics and calculations, conversions you need, those you need to write manually. Okay, so step is an interface created by using Step Builder Factory. Okay, I just want to create a job here. Okay, I just want to create a job here. So step is created by using these details. A job is created by using collection of steps, at least one step required here. Okay. And even you can use one listener, which is actually optional. If you want to execute something before and after the job to know the batch status and all here, that is called job execution listener. This is optional to use. It's a good to use even. Job execution listener. You can see this interface. Okay. It's having a method before job. It's a job execution parameter is there, JE, just I'm writing short, and after job. Okay, JE. So here, if you want to execute something, any logic before the job and after the job, you can use it. Mostly, okay, execution time details, and this job execution, there is a enum available that is called batch status. Batch status, there is an enumeration available. Batch status, if you want to know batch completed, started, starting, stopped, if you want to find out what is the status of the batch at starting and finished, okay, of course initially it will be starting only, so if you want to find out later once job completed, at what time job is completed, so you want to know all the details, job execution listener will be helpful here. It is optional to use. To execute a logic, tracing details, batch status, etc. Before and after job. If you find out all these details here, it will be useful here. Before the job and after the job, you want to execute here. This is a job listener. Okay, and next one is a job object. Of course, it is also interface. Okay, job is created by using Job Builder Factory. It is also class here. Even job needs a name, multiple steps, and execution order, and caller, of course, listener. Okay, if you want to create a job, we are going to use a Job Builder Factory class here that is actually going to take inputs like this. Okay, it is actually going to take multiple inputs and that's actually going to create job object here. To create a job here, these are all required. Okay, let me give a complete technical diagram. How it is going to be even. Okay, this notes, and I'm going to write the code completely. I'll store in my GitHub account. Okay, there you can find out. This is my GitHub account details. Notes and code, complete images will be shared there. GitHub.com/JavaByRaghu. Okay. Even notes and video links you can find out in my Facebook group, The Java Temple. Once class completed, you can access from there. Okay, group/The Java Temple. Okay, we'll continue. Okay, so I just want to create a job here. Okay, so let us see a full technical diagram. What are the different types of classes and files involved in the coding? Initially, this one, I'm highlighting API files only. Repository we discuss later. Leave this numbers and all here. Okay, so there is a job that is having steps, having reader, processor, and writer. Okay, step is actually created by step builder factory. Okay, job is created by job builder factory. Of course, for this, you can pass one listener. Interface, it's a class. Job builder factory and step builder factory. Okay, job builder factory, we can link with job execution listener. Okay, it is an interface, you have to write implementation. Okay, next one, job launcher is an interface. Okay, for this implementation class also given, that is a simple job launcher. It's IMPL class. Just this is a small diagram to understand different types of files involved. Okay. But job launcher is actually taking a method that is a run. Run needs job and job parameters. If you want to give some inputs to your application, something like a client ID, okay, something like internal parameters value, okay, location details, language code, any inputs if you want to pass here, you can just take job parameters. There is a method called run. Okay, so there's actually job parameters, it's a class. Job parameters is a class. But this is actually created by using job parameters builder. Job parameters builder. There is a method available to job parameters by adding the data. After adding the data, this is actually going to convert builder object to job parameters object. Okay, we can pass the inputs to job by using job parameters. By using job parameter builder, you can just call to job parameters method that is given input to job launcher. It will call job, it will execute step, executes reader, processor, and writer here. Okay, this is an input to here. This is actually used to build. Okay, these are API details, which are the different classes involved here. I'm showing. Let me revise. Reader, reading the data from source. Processor, doing some calculations and operation. Writing data to destination. These are all called by step. But step is created by using step builder factory. Step is called by job, but job is created by job builder factory. Some logic is executed before starting the job and after finishing all the steps, that means after completing the job. Okay. And this job is executed by using job launcher. At what date, what time, how many times you want to execute the job, we can configure. It is having a run method. Okay. Okay. So job launcher is actually called by, there's actually implementation is there, simple job launcher, and it is actually going to take some inputs from job parameter. Okay. This is job parameters builder here. Okay. These are the different classes involved. To understand all this, we have to take as a requirement and we are going to see here. Okay. I'll take one small requirement here. We are taking a requirement here. I will be taking one CSV file, comma separated value, CSV. Dot CSV file. Okay, it's actually having some data. Assumption product ID 10, product code pen, it's actually 20 rupees. 11, book 150. Like this, we have a lot of records here. Okay. Now, what I just want to do, this data, I just want to convert it to one MySQL database table. Product ID, product code, product cost, discount, and GST. 10, product code pen, cost 20, discount is assumption some 2 rupees, GST is 4. Like this, I just want to fetch all the records here into a database table. This is a table. Product tab. This is a MySQL database. Okay, we'll take the requirement one here. I just want to read the data from CSV file and write the data to MySQL. You can take 20,000 records also in the CSV file. Here we are giving only three inputs, ID, code, and cost. In the middle, I want to calculate some discount and GST based on some inputs actually, some logics we are going to write here. Okay, this is a batch processing example we are taking. Okay, I just want to implement batch processing for this requirement. So these are all just API details, whatever we have seen here. These are all API details. Now I'll take a requirement. So that is actually reading the data from CSV file and writing the data to MySQL. It's a batch example. Reading data from CSV file and write to MySQL. How it will be? First thing, we'll start from the basic here. Okay, first we need reader, item reader. Don't write item reader manually. There is an item reader available, flat file item reader. By using this item reader, we can read the data from a particular file and we can convert it to objects and give it. Flat file item reader. Okay. Next to processor that we have to write manually. Okay. Because your calculations, your wish here. And next one writer. Okay. JDBC batch item writer. Of course, you can take even JPA batch item writer. JPA item writer, of course, you can take it. Okay, so but I'll start with the JDBC. Okay, these are the two things we are going to use, predefined classes here. Coming to step is created by using a reader implementation class object, processor implementation class object, writer and chunk and name. And step is created by using step builder factory. Job is created by using job builder factory, mainly three files, and remaining we can continue. And this is something like configuration we are going to write. By using cron jobs, we are going to configure this job launcher later. Initially, we concentrate on reader and writer. Okay, we'll see some designing part, then we start some coding here. Okay, observe float file item reader and JDBC batch item writer here. This is a predefined reader given by batch API. Use it to read data from a file and convert it to objects, rows as objects. Okay, writer, JDBC batch item writer here. Of course, this is a predefined writer class given by batch API. Use it to write data to a SQL database. There is a NoSQL database available, that's why especially mentioning SQL database here. Okay. So these are the two important things here. Okay. Again, let us see some full design for this, how it is going to be. Okay. This is CSV file. Assumption I'm just taking, it's a products.csv having some data. It's a 10 pen 200.0, like this I'm just taking, like lot of rows are available, dot 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 I'm just mentioning. First thing, we have to read the data. Okay, second, we have to process it, and then we have to write the data to a database. Okay, our target is actually sending data to database. Okay, I'm showing one combination. If you understand this, even reverse also possible. You want to read the data from database and write to CSV file. Okay. Or if you want to read the data from Mongo database to MySQL, MySQL to XML, XML to CSV. Okay. One concept, if you understand, almost all are similar with a small modifications. We have to choose a proper reader and writer. Okay. Majority of the configuration steps will be same here. Look at plot file item reader. Of course, it follows generic. Every reader follows a generic type. JDBC batch item writer is a class. Okay. First, what it will do, plot file item reader, step number one. Okay. Read file. Okay. Location and name. We have to take it here. That is actually called, there is a method available, set resource. You can take class path resource, file system resource, URL resource. Set resource, nothing but actually linking this file, reading that file. Okay. So once you got the file link, next you have to read the data line by line here. Okay, you have to read the data line by line. Okay, so it can have multiple lines. Just I'm showing example for one line. You may understand remaining here. There is a line mapper. Okay. By using line mapper, so this is one line is taken. Assumption. We got one line data. Okay, then we have to divide the data into individual values. Tokenize the data using delimiter. Delimiter means separator. Here I'm just using comma. Okay, tokenizing nothing but a big string converted into small string here. This is tokenized. This is string number one and string number two. This is individual object now. And once you got the individual values here like this, okay, we have to define one entity class, one model class, and we have to provide some field names. Based on the field names, we have to convert the object. Convert given values into one object. Okay, one object using field names and object type. Okay, this data, we have to define one class for that, something like product class like that here. So this is taking the data and converted like this here. Actually, PROD ID is equals to 10. Okay, PROD code is equals to some pen like this. PROD cost is equals to 2.0, like this. Converted to an object format here. And this object is the output. It is given to processor. It's actually given to processor. But this time, okay, all the values are not calculated if you observe carefully. Okay, there is actually product ID. Fine. Product code. Okay. And product cost. But we just want to calculate product discount. Discount and GST need to be calculated here. That will be done inside the process. We have to define one processor class. Okay. So it will take the input as these three values here and remaining values initially some zero and zero initial values. Okay. That is actually calculated and given. Processor will calculate these values here and then it is actually handover to item writer. JDBC batch item writer. Hey writer. Okay. So I have just done some calculations here. Okay. Take it. Okay. Plot file item reader. First linking the file, reading the data line by line, dividing the data into multiple values by using delimiter comma. That is called tokenizing, converting into an object based on the variable names and types. Internal conversions will be there. Okay. Then hand over this object to processor. We'll do some calculations and give it to JDBC batch item writer. Okay. Once we come to item writer. So the first and important thing here is create a connection with database. Okay. That is called data source. Create a database connection here. That is called data source. Driver class, URL, username, password, we can give something here. Assumption it's a MySQL DB. I just want to write the data to MySQL DB here. Okay, we need a data source initially. Okay, once you get this one here, okay, this data will be collected internally here. Collected into one list, okay, based on one chunk size. While doing the configuration, you have to mention the chunk. Okay, assumption all these objects are collected here. Okay, object 1, object 2, 3, 4, and 5. Assumption chunk I gave 5 size. Okay, then, okay, every object directly you cannot insert into database here. You have to define one SQL query with named parameters. For insert using named params means based on the variable names here, and then okay, generate SQL with the data, okay, that reads the data from object. Okay, one sample SQL is created with the named parameter, something like colon. Okay, that's actually product ID. Okay, at runtime, this SQL is converted to something like it is actually 10. Okay. It will take the data from this object. Okay, named parameter is replaced with some values. Okay, so like that, multiple SQLs. So here we have 5 objects, right? So SQL insert 1, SQL insert 2, SQL insert 3, insert query, SQL insert 4, SQL insert 5. Like that, 5 objects, 5 SQL queries are generated here, and these 5 SQL queries will be returned to database as a single batch here. Give it to database and they're executed here. Okay, this actual flow here you can see. And return to database. Look at the full diagram one more time. Okay, this is actually reading the data from a CSV file, comma separated value, and writing data to a database, MySQL database. First, reader is executed. Okay, locate the file and name. Okay, that is called resource. Read the data line by line, that is line mapper. Convert the data into multiple values, that is called line tokenizer. Convert this data into a particular object type and give it to processor. It will do some calculation. Then hand over to JDBC batch item writer. First, it creates a database connection, that is called data source. Collect the data based on the chunk and define one named parameter query. And at runtime, one object with a query, generate insert query here with the data. Okay. So that is actually will be sent to MySQL database and executed. So finally, if you run, this is actually converted, but it's not the complete code, only reader and writer. Okay, we have to write even step configuration. Okay. Even job configuration, lot of things are there, but mainly reader and writer coding is important here. Okay, so this is session one we have seen here. Continuation means tomorrow we are going to see session 2. Okay. Tomorrow at 10 a.m. we'll be having session 2 continuation. Okay. At that time, I'll be giving coding part. Okay. How can we implement this complete application? I'll be providing here. Okay. Thank you for session. We'll meet in session 2.